Howdy folks, and welcome back to Armoured Warfare with the Mighty Jingles. Today we're taking a look at the French Tier 6 armoured fighting vehicle, the Panhard VBL. It's a four-wheel drive all-terrain armoured fighting vehicle manufactured by Panhard General Defence Systems, mostly for the French Armed Forces, although it does see extensive use in other countries as well, typically former French colonies, although even Russia has 500 of these things on order. This thing gets around a bit. There are actually more than 2,300 VBLs operational with 16 different armies worldwide, although the majority, 1,600 of them, are in service with the French Army. It's primarily used in the reconnaissance and patrol role, although it can also be outfitted to work as an anti-tank vehicle or an air defence vehicle. It has an all-welded steel hull, which only offers a Stanag 1 level of protection. It's sufficient to protect the crew from NATO 7.62mm and shrapnel, as well as anti-personnel mines, but an RPG, 50 caliber machine gun, or an anti-tank mine is going to make a real mess of this tiny little vehicle. It's 4.09 meters long, 2.02 meters wide, and the height to the top of the roof is 1.7 meters. It can accommodate up to 4 crew members. Combat weight of the vehicle is 4,000 kilograms, and it's able to carry a payload of up to 900 kilograms. Depending on who's operating the vehicle, it's powered by either a Peugeot 95 horsepower engine or a Steyr 125 horsepower engine coupled to a ZF 4-speed automatic gearbox. The engine provides a maximum speed of 95 kilometers per hour, and the 100 litre fuel tank allows the vehicle to travel a distance of anything between 600 to 800 kilometers depending on the terrain. It's equipped with a central tyre inflation system for better mobility across different terrain, and it can negotiate a side slope of 30% and a gradient of 50%. It's also an amphibious vehicle. With the optional amphibious kit, it can swim at a speed of 5.4 kilometers. It's fully air transportable, even by helicopter. So, why would you want to be driving the VBL in armored warfare? It only has 11 millimeters of armor and is equipped with a 20 millimeter autocannon. Why would you want to be driving this tiny little thing when you could be driving a main battle tank like the Challenger, or the T-80, or the Leopard? Allow me to explain. So, looking at the stats. Alpha damage with the 20mm autocannon firing armor piercing, 34, and it only has 109mm of penetration, so you're not going to be taking on many main battle tanks from the front with this thing. Sustained damage per minute is off the charts, 6,410. But again, that's highly subjective. That's assuming that you're able to make every shot count and it penetrates the target that you're firing at. It only has 875 hit points. Mobility is off the charts, however. Maximum speed, with my equipment configuration, of 95.63 kilometers per hour, and it'll do 0 to 32 kilometers per hour in 2.1 seconds. But it's its camouflage and view range that is what makes this thing special. The camo rating is excellent. The view range is phenomenal. Moving at top speed, this thing has a view range, again with my equipment configuration, which isn't as high as I can get the view range with access to more advanced and more expensive equipment retrofits, 565 meters. And that's on the move. When stationary, this little thing gains an extra 40 meters of view range. That's 605 meters view range. And once I've researched Augmented Optics Mark III, I can push that even higher. Armour is of course absolutely terrible. This thing only has 11mm of armour. There isn't a gun in the game that would fail to penetrate the VBL. But getting shot at is not what this thing's for. Spotting targets and having your team shoot at them for you, that is what this thing excels at. The commander that I use on this thing is Sabrina Washington, and she's one of the two default commanders that you start Armoured Warfare with, and she's very, very good on machines like Armoured Fighting Vehicles, the Scouts, and also the Tank Destroyers. She gets three crew skills once she's fully trained that are very, very useful. Vigilant, which is the default skill that she comes with, increases your view range by 40 meters. She also has Blending In, which increases your camo factor by 10%, and at Tier 4, the Hidden Gunner crew skill, which reduces the visibility penalty while shooting through concealment by 30%, all very, very useful, both for armoured fighting vehicles and tank destroyers. But I can tell you're still not convinced. I mean, yeah, okay, Jingles, it's all very well and good not being spotted, but when you do get spotted, you're in a vehicle with 11mm of armour, so, you know, good night. Well, yeah, but the trick, of course, is in not being spotted in the first place, and with that, when stationary, 605 meter view range, that's relatively easy. And if you do get spotted, the trick becomes not being hit, and this thing will do 0 to 32 in 2.1 seconds and has a top speed of 95 kilometers per hour and is a very, very small target, so it's actually a lot easier than you might think. And to demonstrate, we're going to show you a couple of games that I played in the VBL. One PvE co-op mission and two PvP player versus player battles. So this is Operation Sapphire. It's a cooperative PvE battle, and it's the first time I'd ever seen it. This is one of the new maps and missions that was introduced in the patch that was released for Armored Warfare just before Christmas. I have never played on this map before. I have no idea where to go. I have no idea what to do when I get there. I don't know where the enemy vehicles are likely to spawn from. I haven't got a clue. Not one. So I'm pretty much just playing this one, you know, I'm just reacting to what's going on around me. I realise that I'm in an armoured fighting vehicle, so I need to find some concealment and try not to drive into the rocks. Those of you who play the wheeled vehicles in Armoured Warfare will understand exactly what I'm struggling with here. They tend to be very, very fast and very, very light on the controls. It is very easy to oversteer when you're driving one of these things and put it into a spin or end up driving into rocks or trees that you didn't mean to. It doesn't take long for you to get the hang of it, however. I exclusively use the 20mm autocannon on this thing, and we'll go into the reasons why in a moment. For now, I'm just trying to anticipate, because I've never played this map before, exactly where the enemy vehicles are going to spawn from. Remember, this thing only has 11mm of armour, and it only has 875 hit points. A Soviet main battle tank firing high explosive anti-tank shaped charge ammunition. Oh crap. wait, I haven't been spotted. Yeah, you can't be one-shotted by anything in Armored Warfare. It's hard-coded into the game. But you'll notice I didn't get spotted when firing through all this concealment here, and did detect those vehicles as they spawned. But yes, you can't be one-shotted by anything in Armored Warfare. Not if you're on full health when they hit you. Oh, this was actually quite amusing. I'm crossing the open ground here in order to try to get some spotting opportunities on these guys over here towards the objective. Pay attention to the map, because I'm going to get surprised by one of the respawns. Oh, I've been detected. Oh my god, no, run away! Run away! Running away is something this thing is very, very, very good at. And I've got an even better example of it in the first of the PvP matches that I'm going to show you. But it's very easy to get into trouble in the VBL, but it's very, very easy to get out of trouble in the VBL as well. Once again, I have absolutely no idea where I'm going. I'm just looking at the map and thinking, okay, where can I go to get some spots? To use the Armored Fighting Vehicle class mechanic to designate a target and get some spotting and assistance damage done in this thing. It's not that you can't actually do any damage in the VBL yourself, although it only has the 20mm autocannon. You can. I've had games where I've actually come top on damage done. And that wasn't as a result of having a bad team either. It's just getting around the flanks, getting around the rear, and shooting at them while they're busy engaged with other targets to their front. Or shooting at them from way outside of the detection range. Okay, I've been spotted here, but oh no, he's pointing his gun this way, I need to get out of here. Which again, very, very easy to do in the VBL. This thing is not very forgiving of making mistakes, I will say that much. Because it's got terrible armor, and because it doesn't have an awful... Oh my god, I've done it again. Main battle tanks, run away! I mean, here it comes. Oh, they missed. Get this thing turned around and motor back the way I came. Try to avoid... Oh, that one was close. That one actually... No damage taken. I think it just missed. And... Oh, no, this isn't good. I've taken a hit from the rear, but I've got the rear of this guy. I ain't going to stop. Not with fresh main battle tanks spawning behind me. I'm just going to keep going and get the hell out of here. So, once again... Got myself into trouble because I didn't have a clue where I was going or what I was going to do when I got there. But I'm in a VBL and escaped with relatively minor consequences. I'm down to 653 health, which means that now I can be one-shot killed by, well, typically a Soviet main battle tank firing a shaped charge shell, high explosive anti-tank. They can do 700 damage in a hit. So now I really do need to be careful. One chance is really all you get in this thing. You really don't want to go pushing your luck. Alright, there's a nice big fat main battle tank on full health, so I'm going to designate him, and hopefully my team are going to pound the crap out of him, because when you've been lit up like this by an armoured fighting vehicle, anybody who hits and penetrates the target, come on, somebody hit and penetrate the target, will do the full damage range of whatever the damage range of the gun they're firing at him is. But no wasted opportunity. Obviously nobody had a shot at him, or they were far more interested in shooting at the targets that were easier to damage, like these light tanks. Look at that autocannon go. Flanking shots like this. I'm really piling up the damage done here. Have a look at that. That's a few kills. So far I've killed two Stingray 2 light tanks, which isn't bad. Obviously it's easier to kill a light tank than a main battle tank, unless you manage to get the main battle tank from the certain parts of the side or the rear. I was getting so excited in this match, I am using the wrong ammunition here. At the moment I'm firing the armor piercing. I should be firing, and I've been spotted while designating this leopard. Need to back off, break line of sight, bingo, there we go, no longer detected. I should be firing the high explosive incendiary ammunition, particularly at targets like these. It's still not going to penetrate, but the high explosive incendiary ammunition doesn't have to penetrate to do damage. It won't do a lot of damage, but it does better than no damage, which is what happens if you continue trying to fire 20mm armor piercing at the front and certain parts of the sides of these high-tier main battle tanks. The VBL is a tier 6 armored fighting vehicle. On the team we have a tier 7, and that means we're fighting, well, some tier 9 enemies, like the Leopard 2A6, the tier 8s, like the Leopard 2A5, for example. What do we got? Oh, light tank, I can hurt him. Let's designate him while we're reloading. And bingo. Now we're doing the full damage range. I'm scoring a couple of crits as well. In fact, lots of crits. Come on. No, didn't get to kill him, but did almost all of that guy's health. Oh, wait, maybe I will get to kill him. Come on. Yep, did it. Got him. Fantastic. So that's three Stingrays, two Mark IIs and a Mark I. Not bad. Not bad for something that's basically a Ford Fiesta with a 20mm autocannon mounted on top. And what do we got next? Let's have a look. Okay. Oh, a BMP-2. I can nail him. No problem. Just the way the damage piles up. There's the BMP-2 now. We'll kill number four. 4,700 damage done. Not lacking targets. You'll notice in the notification window, just there above the minimap, constantly spotting targets over and over. I'm just going to designate this C1 Ariete. It's a tier 8 main battle tank. It's an Italian tank, not bad. My team don't appear to be willing to shoot him. So, okay, I will instead. Going for the engine compartment at the rear. And I'm penetrating with most of the shots that I'm firing. Going for the reload. Can I kill this guy? That'd be pretty nice. And you know what? I think, yes, I have killed a tier 8 main battle tank and I've been spotted. That's not good. Killing a main battle tank. Oh crap, there's a Bradley behind me. No. Bradley is also a tier 6 armored fighting vehicle. Completely different to the VBL, of course. It's not as fast. It doesn't have quite as good a view range. But he's not looking at me, and he's going to be sorry, but I've run out of ammo, and let's get back into cover, because he will be looking at me now. and he's got a very nasty autocannon, and a missile launcher on the top. That's the thing about the VBL, you have to choose between the autocannon or the missile launcher, and I tried the missile launcher, because I thought, well, yeah, definitely, lots of damage, four shots, plenty of reloads, what's not to like? Unfortunately, the thing is, you are in a machine that only has 11mm of armor. And the thing about firing the anti-tank guided missiles is, well, they're not as fast as an armor-piercing projectile from a 20mm autocannon. They're actually quite slow. I wonder if that Bradley is... No, I've been spotted again. It was probably the Bradley. And when you're firing these anti-tank guided missiles, you have to guide them to the target. And there's a good chance that while you're doing that... See if I can get this Bradley. There's a good chance while you're doing that you've been spotted. And you have to sit there stationary, guiding the missile to the target. I have been spotted. Wait, that's not the Bradley. That's artillery. Oh, I'm gonna have some fun here. I'll lock on. Spotted an M1A2 as well. Come on, come on. Keep moving, keep moving, keep moving. And spotted another artillery off to my right. That's the tier 8. Okay, we're going to auto-fire, and oh, there it is, the Panzerhaubitzer is opening up, he's fired one, he's fired two, there's his third shot. Now, I'm going to have him. Expend my remaining ammo, I can guarantee you I'm going to beat his reload. Designate him as a target, get the maximum damage out of these shells, and bingo, kill number 8. It's surprising how much damage you can do in this little terror of a machine. I really, really enjoy playing this machine. What it reminds me of is what it used to be like to drive the Oh, there's the Bradley, and I think I can probably finish him off. Maybe. I've not been spotted, by the way, have you realised this? I'm just lighting this guy up. Oh, I've been spotted now. Right, time to move. Bradley's got a nasty little autocannon as well. Bradley's going to live to fight another day. Or is he? Actually, no. The Bradley's been taken out. Okay. I didn't get the kill, but I did the majority of the damage to him. But yes, what this machine reminds me of is driving the T-50-2 back in World of Tanks when light tanks were actually good. That's exactly what this thing is like. It is so much fun. I really, really enjoy playing this machine. I think we've pretty much got this now. There's not an awful lot of time left. I'll switch to the high explosive incendiary ammunition now. Although I'm hitting obstacles. I'm not actually hitting the target. Let's get around. Close in and finish these guys off. Oh, watch out. These things are so hard to steer. Can I ninja a kill? Or can I get one of the secondaries? Normally this is one of the things that you tend to do in armored fighting vehicles when you're playing these co-op battles. Get the secondaries. There's nothing left to kill, but oh, there's a secondary there. Can I? We're not going to get all of them. The map's about to run out. Come on. Get down. It's extra points. Screw it. Bingo. There we go. And game over. One successful Operation Sapphire. The first time I had ever seen this map. Didn't have a clue where to go, what to do when I got there. But what fun. What fun in this absolute little terror of a tier 6 armored fighting vehicle. 22, nearly 23,000 experience out of that. Okay, I'm running a premium account. This was the first win of the day. I was also running a consumable that boosted my experience by 50%, but that's still pretty impressive. And I didn't even come first on the team. Have a look at the assistance damage. Yep. Not bad at all. It's a shame my team couldn't do more damage to targets than I was designating, but just the spotting damage alone made for a lot of experience earned in this match. Didn't earn an awful lot of credits, however, and that's the major difference in rewards between PvP and PvE. If you want to earn lots and lots of credits, you play PvP. The rewards are far, far better. And so, that's what we're going to do next. We're going to show you a couple of PvP matches. This match was actually a bit of a disaster. I was trying to get my daily double in PvP rather than PvE, which is what I normally do. I was saving up money to buy the C1 Ariete, the tier 8 main battle tank. I've got it now, by the way. It's a very, very good tank, even completely stock. Unfortunately, this team just wasn't really interested in shooting anything that I spotted for them, so it was a bit of a waste of time. But there were a couple of moments in this match that are worth paying attention to. So, I don't know what the hell I hit there, but anyway, let's get up here and see what we can see with my, while stationary, 605-meter view range. I was a little slow to get into position here, and didn't get the initial spots off, but once in this position, targets started popping up, including, I feel quite guilty shooting at this little fella, but he's on the enemy team. So, yeah, scored a couple of hits, forced him to fall back, and now the spots are popping up. Multiple targets, including that VFM over there. Tell you what, we're going to attempt to persuade the team to start shooting at things and killing them. A forlorn hope, of course. And there he is again. He's back, the little bugger. And there's the first kill on the team. I have, of course, been spotted. Pull back, dodge a shot, swing it around, out of line of sight. No longer detected. Let's get back up there. You'll notice that the target I've designated has taken absolutely zero damage. Well, of course he has. I mean, why would anybody bother to shoot at a target that you're going to do full damage to? And this is where things start to go horribly, horribly wrong. Somebody else on the team has actually managed to kill something. Hurrah, but we've lost three tanks, and I'm constantly being spotted over here. We've got one MBT-70, and all of the light tanks behind him are turning around and running away. So, while I really don't want to abandon the MBT-70, I'm going to have to run away as well, because I only have 11mm of armour, and that position has become untenable. So I've managed to break line of sight, but I am going to get spotted again as I crest this rise, because I stop at the top to turn around and try to light these targets up for the tank destroyers behind me, but I'm just a little bit too close, so instead I'm going to have to run away. And this is where things get amusing. See if you can count the shots that get fired at me here. As I go all Neo from the Matrix on them. This was exhilarating, let me tell you that. Look at this. You can't hit me, suckers. Oh, this machine is amazing. This was, of course, a horrible, horrible, horrible defeat. Everybody camped at the back, and the guys that did go forward were incapable of actually killing anything, you know, except for me. We've still only killed... Oh, no, we've managed to nail our third tank. Hurrah, here we go. I'll designate this guy, put some shots into him. High explosive incendiary ammunition. Oh, shit, I've been spotted, and bang, there you go, dead. Okay. Yeah, this was a terrible, terrible game, but that moment when what felt like half the enemy team were all shooting at me at the same time, and only one of them managed to score a hit, that's the sort of thing that happens when you're driving the VBL in PvP quite a lot. Anyway, that was a horrible, horrible defeat. Believe it or not, I actually finished... I got the recon medal, first of all. I spotted 11 of the 15 vehicles on the enemy team, and finished third on experience. Only did 371 damage. That's how much this team sucked. My assistance damage from spotting those 11 enemy vehicles, how much damage did my team manage to do to them? Yeah, less than 3,000. Yeah, that team sucked. And to be honest, I wasn't that good either. So let's have another go and see if we can do any better. This was the very next game, and once again, never seen this map before. I really don't play PvP in Armored Warfare a lot, I hardly play PvP in Armored Warfare at all, so no idea where to go or what to do. However, somebody on the team in chat at the beginning said, VBL, spot in the middle please. So, okay, right, he obviously has a better idea of what's going on in this map than I do. Knock some trees over, give myself some additional concealment, and immediately get my first two spots. It's only now that I actually start paying attention to the map and saying, oh yeah, it's a sort of encounter mode. There's a capture point right in the middle of the map, and there's more spots. Oh, I've been spotted, fall back, and whoa, that was actually friendly fire. That nearly killed me. That went right through the spot where I was. What the hell? Pace. Have a bit of care, chaps. I'm trying to spot targets here for you. And... I obviously got here far too... I mean, I don't think I've done any assistance damage yet, not from spotting targets, because 95 kilometers per hour, this thing, again, 0 to 32 in 2.1 seconds. I got here so fast that when I got the initial spots, I don't think there was anybody else on my team really in a position to take advantage of it. However, I should... There we go. Light this guy up. No, not quite. No, I couldn't really get the lock on him. Maybe now. You'll notice the white eye icon over the vehicle. That means that I'm the one spotting him. There we go. People are starting to do some damage. When you see the white eye icon over a vehicle, that's the game telling you that you are the one who has spotted that target. And so any damage done to that vehicle while you see that white eye icon over that vehicle is going to go towards your spotting and assistance damage. I've managed to designate that fella. And I'm just sitting here. I'm not going to fire my gun unless I have to. And I've been spotted. Pull back, pull back, pull back. There he goes. He fired and he missed. When you've got that big yellow eye icon, that means somebody has direct line of sight to you and can see you. You have been detected. When it fades to a smaller but still yellow icon, it means that while he doesn't necessarily have direct line of sight to you, you are still detected. You have to wait for it to fade to white and then disappear. That means you're no longer being spotted. Lighten more targets up, taking a couple of shots of opportunity at targets. Though I've been detected. Back up, back up. Dodged some incoming fire there. I think that was from the light tank with his 57mm gun. Not going too well. We've lost the tank. Haven't managed to kill anything yet. But I'm not detected. This fox is playing a dangerous game up here. He doesn't have the concealment that I do from the bushes here. So he's probably getting spotted every time he pops out to try to light a target up. The fox is a nice little machine as well, by the way. I'm just going to designate this leopard because it's a leopard. And I can actually penetrate him. And I've done some damage. And scored some criticals. I'm firing the high explosive incendiary here, by the way. I've learned my lesson. Although I could maybe penetrate a leopard with the armor piercing, but I know I'm going to do some damage with the armor, with the high explosive. Detect it again, repeat the process, fall back, wait, and it's safe to move forward. Although I'm checking the map out, wondering if I'm going to be needed elsewhere. But this position seems to be, I mean, this is the capture point, this is where the battle actually takes place. You win this particular version of the Narrows map by occupying the cap point, which is almost never going to happen because it's right in the middle of the map. But it's where it concentrates the fighting. This particular version of the Narrows usually ends with one team being completely wiped out. It's very difficult to actually cap here. Although there is somebody there in the cap circle. I think it's the B1 Centauro. I really need to detect that guy. Because I'm the guy on the spot. I'm the one most easily... There he is. Oh, that was close. But it's forced him out of the cap circle, so he's no longer capping. He's no longer able to stealth cap and steal a win that way. Five tanks dead on each team. This could go either way. There he is. No, actually, no, it's an MBT. Light him up. Come on, somebody shoot him. Give him a quick dose of high explosive. And I took a hit. And that was a big old hit. That was actually quite lucky. That was the MBT-70 with his 152mm gun. That would have been an armor-piercing hit. If that had been high explosive anti-tank, if that had been a shaped charge round from that thing, I would have probably only had about 50 health left. That's how much damage that thing does. So, again, that was my one and only chance. You only get one chance in the VBL. You can't be one-shotted from full health in Armored Warfare. But now I've taken a hit. I only have 420 health. Pretty much anything can one-shot kill me, other than somebody firing an autocannon. So I need to be very, very careful. I've been spotted. Let's not take any chances. I was contemplating hanging around and designating that guy, but no, not when I've been detected. It's just too risky. And I've about had enough of this guy in chat, so I'm going to register a complaint against him. The standard of player behaviour in chat in Armored Warfare PvP is absolutely disgraceful. Obviously, I've seen some pretty despicable behaviour in other online games, but Armored Warfare... I guess it's just lucky I never played League of Legends. I hear it's pretty bad there. This guy's on such low health, no, been spotted, pull back. Not worth the risk. The high explosive incendiary ammunition will do some damage most of the time, but it depends on the thickness of the armor where the shots hit. And while that guy was on very, very low health, the turret of that MBT-70 is so heavily armored that it really wasn't worth the effort. It gave my position away, and I would have been better off just designating them as a target and letting somebody else shoot it up. I do believe we're actually winning. 9 tanks remaining against 7. Somebody's furiously pinging the map back over there on the northern flank, and I think he does actually have a point. Oh, well, there we go. Spotted one, but he's nailed the artillery. Spotted another one. He's on very low health. Can I kill him? He's got some hits. Damaged his tracks and his fuel tank, I think. Let's get around and see if we can steal some kills. They've nailed one of the ones that I spotted. Can I finish this guy? It's got to be worth a try. Oh, no. But Spot and damage, I had him detected. And it looks like that Centauro was trying to steal the cap again. But I'm heading in this direction anyway, so let's see if I can get around behind him. There's only four of them left. It's almost like driving a French autoloader in World of Tanks. You have to look after your health and try to survive until as late in the game as possible, because those machines become a lot more dangerous the longer they survive, when they can actually start killing stuff. That's not the Centauro. Oh, there goes the Centauro. He's running away. Let's see if we can nail this guy. And, yep, we got him, but I did get spotted, and I really don't want to get shot by the Centauro. But no, he's not interested. He's trying to get out of there. Several friendly tanks in hot pursuit. Can I catch up? Can I ninja another kill? Come on, move. This thing's supposed to be fast. Oh, watch out for the rocks. It really is very, very hard to steer this thing. Come on. Nearly there. No, they've killed him. Okay, just the artillery left. Where's he going to be? No idea. He's got to be down here somewhere. Am I going to turn left? Am I going to turn right? I've got friendly tanks approaching from the left, so I'm going to turn right. Surely he's around here. Come on. There he is. And come on. Yes, got him. Hooray. That was a lot of fun. And also very, very profitable in comparison to playing in co-op mode. You earn more or less the same amount of reputation or experience, as most people refer to it, as you do in PvP. But the credit rewards are vastly better in PvP. It's entirely possible to unlock every machine and every upgrade in the game just playing co-op battle, but you'll never be able to afford to pay for them. So how did we do in that one? Unbelievably. Look at that, the gold star award. The gold star award for the most reputation earned, and the recon medal. I spotted every single vehicle on the enemy team. Look at that. Every single tank on the enemy team at some point I detected in that match in the VBL on the Narrows map. How much assistance damage? Not that much, actually. And I didn't do that much damage myself, but it's all from the spots. 15 spots. It's very, very profitable. Assistance damage, let's have a look. I think it was only around about 3,500. There it is. Oh, actually, no, more than that. That's not too bad. I'd hoped it would have been a bit more, given the number of targets that I actually spotted. You know, all of them. But I'll settle for that. And, of course, you have to take into account that they're trying not to get shot. So, you know, it's all well and good spotting them. That's easy. But actually landing shots on target, that's another matter. So, anyway, that's the Panhard Defense Systems BBL, French. Tier 6 armored fighting vehicle in Armored Warfare. It's an absolute metric arse ton of fun. It really, really reminds me, playing this thing both in co-op and PvP, just like the old T-50-2 Tier 5 Russian light tank in World of Tanks, back in the days when light tanks actually had a point in World of Tanks. It is just as much fun as that little monster. I have had an amazing time playing this thing, and I can highly recommend it. Anyway, that's it for today, folks. As always, take care, have fun playing whatever you're playing, and I'll catch you next time.